Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how you can export your notes using a script. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So recently I did a video on how to export your reminders using a script. This is important because there's really no way to export or even copy and paste reminders out of the Reminders app in Catalina. Now Notes is a little bit better. You can certainly export a single note. Matter of fact, you can do it as a PDF and get a really good copy of it. But you can only do them one at a time. So if you have a lot of notes, it's very difficult if you want to export all your notes just to back them up. So here's a script that will easily export all of your notes as HTML files. So here's the script in Script Editor. Script Editor is on your Mac and it just lets you write scripts, kind of like Automator, but all you're doing is actually scripting and it's more powerful because of that. Anything you do in Script Editor though, you can actually do in Automator by using an action that's a script action. In this case, I'm using JavaScript, not AppleScript. So I created a new document here and I switched to JavaScript. So I can use the more modern programming language rather than the old AppleScript. And here's what the script looks like. At the beginning, I'm defining two variables that are apps. The first one is the current application, so Script Editor, since I'm going to run this in Script Editor. And then there's the Notes app, which I'm specifically saying I want the application Notes right here. And on both, I'm including standard editions, which means I can actually control them. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is choose which notes out of all the notes I've got. So I'm saying variable notes is going to equal the Notes app and all notes in it, which is a property called .notes. Then I'm going to use a choose from list from my main app, which is Script Editor, app.choose from list. Then I'm going to get that list here of notes, but just the names. And I'm going to have a prompt, which really isn't that important, but I am going to allow multiple selections. So you can select one or many of the items listed. This is important because mostly we want to use this to export all notes. Then I'm going to check to see if I actually got a value back. If not, it means that I clicked the cancel button, so don't continue any further. Now I'm going to prompt again for choose folder, so choose a location of where to save these. And I'm going to save that in a saveWhere variable. And I'm going to check to make sure I got a value for that. If not, it's because I hit cancel, so it won't do anything after this. Now I'm going to loop through all the notes, not the notes I selected, but all of the notes in the Notes app. And for each one, I'm going to compare it to my list of notes that I've selected. So the prompt that I had asking for all the notes, I'm going to compare it using index of. So it's going to look in those notes that I selected and get the index of. Now the index of, if it's not found, will return -1. So it's not one of the notes I selected in the list, I'll get a -1. I'm going to look for something greater than -1, which means it is in the notes that I've selected. So this will be true for every single one if I chose to export all notes. But if I only chose to export some notes, then this will only be true for those that I selected in the list. Then I'm going to do a simple save file. So I'm going to create a file name that's going to be the location of where I selected up here. Then it's going to take the name of the note and I'm going to append .html to the end of it since these are going to be HTML files. Then I'm going to create a new file, open it up with that path, that file name there, and set write permission to true. Now when JavaScript does this in Script Editor, it's going to start writing the file at the beginning, but it won't clear it out. So you need to do this. You need to set the end of file to 0. In other words, clear the file out. So if we're doing it for the second time, we want it to clear out the notes and create new files, not overwrite what's in the note, which may make a mess. Then it'll write it out and close the file. And that's all that we need to do. So if we run this, it's going to show me a list of all of my notes. I can select them individually. I can use the Command key to select multiple ones. I can use Shift to select a range, or I can do Command A to select them all. So quick Command A selects them all, and then I can click OK or hit Return. It's going to ask for a location. Let's go and save it to the desktop, but I'm going to create a new folder since this is the first time I'm running it. And then I'll hit Create, and then I'm in that folder now, and I'll select Choose to choose that as the location. It'll export them all out. You saw it running there for a second. I'm going to hide it and there's my exported notes folder. I go into that and I can see all of those HTML files. I can look at each one. Let me hit the space bar to quick look with it and there's that one. I'll arrow down to the next one and you can see each one there. Now note it's exporting as HTML. It's going to look a little different than what's in the note, but it is going to preserve some of the formatting. As a matter of fact, You'll even see some attachments, but not all. And you'll even see things like tables in there. So HTML is a good format to export to. It's not going to be perfect, but it will create a good backup and a way to copy and paste out of that if you need to recover something in an old note. One thing to note is that the titles for each of these notes need to be good file names. So if you have dots or slashes or something in the titles here, then you're going to get error messages. So make sure the first line of each note is something nice and clean, because that's going to be the file name. Also in Script Editor, if you go to Window, Library, and then in Library you go to Notes there, double click on that, it will open up the library for notes, switch to JavaScript, and click Notes Suite. And this shows you all the different things that you could do with notes inside of JavaScript. So note here, here's that note object that we're using in the script, and that's where I got body from right there. But you can see there's also plain text. So if you want to export as plain text and save .txt files instead of .html, that's how you can do it. Now if I wanted to, I could export this and save it out as an application. So I'm going to put that on the desktop, save it out. Then I'm going to hide Script Editor there, and I'm going to try running this one here. It's going to ask for permissions because this is the first time this application has been run. So I'll hit OK, and I can still select everything, and then it's going to ask for a new location. So let me create a new folder, and I'll save it out there. And you could see it worked just as well as a standalone application. It's just easier to have it sometimes as a script in Script Editor so that you can easily modify it and play around with it as your needs evolve. Since these are HTML files, when you double click on them, they open up in Safari, which is fine and easy enough to copy and paste or view them. This is a great way to ensure that your data is saved and go back to older notes you may have deleted. But it's not great for restoring notes if you've lost them all. Still, it's good to know that your data is saved and you can access it in case of a problem. And it's also a handy way to export a bunch of notes to clean out your Notes app with notes you don't need anymore, but you want to make sure you have an archive of them before you delete them. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.